just one name. Jesus, oh Jesus. I know a name that's higher than any other name, and at the mention every knee will bow one day. There is just one name, oh
Jesus, fear and anxiety. What you feel here today is the realest thing you will ever experience in your life. You know, there's a lot of knockoffs. There's a lot of things that you can get that look like the real thing. They put an emblem on there, and it looks like it's what it's supposed to be. But what's on the inside isn't real. We've known different companies, soft drinks. It's the real thing. I'm here to tell somebody this morning, what you're experiencing today is the real thing. There's nothing like the power and the anointing of Jesus Christ in our life. There's nothing like it. Many men have died. Men that claimed power. Men that claimed anointing. Many have died. But there's only one that rose again from the dead, because he holds all power in heaven and earth in his hands. Hallelujah. We've only just begun in this service, but there's something mighty that's stirring in this house right now. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. God is about to speak to somebody's life this morning. I'm just asking that you be open. Open your mind, open your heart, and listen to the voice. As you're standing, we're going to go before the Lord in prayer. Let's pray for Gary Smith this morning. He needs healing in his body. Amen. If you have a need, by an upraised hand, amen. God knows your need. We're going to open this front as we begin to sing again. We're going to pray with you. We're going to believe with you. God's going to do the work in your life. Amen. We invite you to come down. Let's go before him in prayer right now. Lord Jesus, we thank you, God, for your power, your strength. We thank you for your promises, Lord Jesus. I thank you for going to a cross and dying for me and getting stripes upon your back by which I can be healed. And I pray right now, Lord Jesus, that your strength go forward. Let your healing power reach down. God, that you would heal every life, Lord, every sickness, every disease, Lord, that you would put families back together, Lord. God, that you would put lives back together this morning. I pray right now, Jesus, let your anointing move, healing power in Jesus' name.
Show us your glory. Let everybody. change everything. Lives healed, hope found here right now. Jesus, you change everything.
Chains fall. Change everything. Lives healed, hope found here now. Jesus, you change everything. Chains fall, fear bow here now. Jesus, you change everything.
Lift your hands and sing that to Him. Show us your glory, God. God's doing a work. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you for your power, your anointing, God. Show us your glory. Come on, can you lift your hands and thank Him for what He's doing? God, we're so thankful. God, we're so grateful. We don't take for granted the season that we're in, God. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. What a wonderful Savior. There's nothing like His presence and His power. And God is doing great things. We're rejoicing over what God is doing, right? Right now, in this season that we're in. Praise God. Let's get everything that we can. If you have family members that need the Holy Ghost, if you have co-workers, if you're driving to church and you see someone on the side of the road that needs the Holy Ghost, just bring them. We're in a season where God is blessing and God is pouring out His Spirit upon all flesh. Come on. And He wants to do it for you. And for your family. Praise God. Brother Chris Poole. My friend. I've got a Holy Ghost certificate. Come on up here, brother. Yes, Lord. Brother Chris. Brother Chris, something happened on Easter Sunday. Got the text message. Going to make this church my home church. I said, brother, this is awesome. This made my day. I told Brother Trimble, this made my day. Show up to church next Sunday after Easter. Brother Chris is in a suit and tie. Not that you have to wear that. But he was ready. He was going to see the King. And I noticed during that Sunday, Brother Chris sat on the edge of his seat. When we were worshiping, Brother Chris was one of the first on his feet. I had just announced that he was making this his home church. And Brother Chris is on the edge of his seat saying, ain't nobody going to out-worship me. On my first Sunday, I'm going to be the worshiper. Amen. When the preacher was preaching and we'd stand up, I'd see Brother Chris over there. Hey, preach on, preacher. So church is over. Church is over. And we're having a tag-in meeting with our department heads up in the hyphen room. And we're gonna meet. And as I'm walking out, I feel a tug on my suit jacket. It's Brother Rick Toadbine. He said, as only he can do, hey, Pastor, I don't know if you know. I love Brother Rick. Brother Chris got the Holy Ghost. I was on my way to a department meeting and I stopped in my tracks and said, look what the Lord is doing in this season. I better give this to you before I wrinkle it. I'm just so happy. We're so thankful. This goes to show you right here that if you are hungry and you are ready, God wants to fill you with His Spirit. It doesn't have to take years. It can take one moment in His presence to say, God, I'm here and I'm ready. Praise God. We're rejoicing with Brother Chris. We're rejoicing with Sister Andrea and the family. God is doing great things in this family. Amen. Amen. And these, I believe, are a direct result of sweet Sister Trimble and her prayers and every dance that she danced up here in the sanctuary. Amen. Hey, keep on praising. Keep on worshiping. God's going to bring them home. Amen. We love you, Brother Chris. God bless you. Come on. Thank God for what He's doing in the family. Praise God. Praise God. Brother Chris, the youth service last Wednesday, they had church in the family center. Brother Chris said, we just had to keep going. Brother Riley, Sister Michaela were down there playing the music, and something gripped that service. And Brother Chris started preaching in the plan of salvation, and he asked, who wants the Holy Ghost? And about five young people raised their hand. I want the Holy Ghost. Come on, that's a big step. I want the Holy Ghost. Three came and talked to him after service and said, Brother Chris, I think I'd like to get baptized. In Jesus' name. The plan of salvation was presented. The plan of salvation was received. And after talking with parents and making sure everything is right, we're going to baptize them in the name that's above every name. Look what the Lord is doing in this season. Praise God. Praise God. So we thank God for every P7 club. We thank God for every young person that is reaching, that is ministering and talking to their friends. They want to hear it more than we want to tell it. So if we'll just start telling it, they'll come in and receive it in Jesus' name. Praise God. Praise God. Before we go to the offering, we have been praying for this service. I talked to Brother Devin Cunningham just recently about coming and preaching to us and singing to us. And I told him in the office, brother, just get ready, because the season that we're in, anything can happen. And anything's going to happen. But we're so thankful. I'm going to introduce him now before we take up the offering and the choir comes up, because he's just going to come up after the choir, sing with them, and just take it from there. So I just want to say, Brother Cunningham, we are so thankful to have you in our church today. We've been praying for this service. We've been believing and fasting, knowing that God is going to do the incredible. Amen. And this is the last time that he'll be here single, because in 68 days, he told me 68 days. I think they're excited. They got it down to 68 days. He is going to marry Sister Camille from Louisiana. Come on, somebody. Amen. And so we congratulate him. We are so thankful for him and his ministry. God is doing great things. He has traveled with multiple groups. Aqua. He was here with Master's Legacy Quartet with Brother Faulkner, and Brother Denny was here. And then he has traveled with Right Road Quartet. And then now he is evangelizing and going around the church singing and preaching. And we're going to be blessed today. Amen. But we're not going to sit back and watch. We are going to worship with Brother Cunningham. Amen. So at this time, Brother Daniel is going to come to take up the tithe and offering. And then we're going to move into the choir. And then Brother Cunningham is just going to take it. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Hang on here. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're going to receive your tithing and offering. I'm not going to come take you down. I'm not going to take it, but the Lord is going to receive it. Amen. We just want you to give your best offering. We want you to be blessed of the Lord. There's promises attached with giving. They're available to all of us. Amen. Amen. God is so good. If you would like to give your tithing offering, building fund, save our children's offering, or children, not children's, save our children offering, you're welcome to do that. And I'm going to be brief. Let's just pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you, God, for the opportunity to give back to your kingdom. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to bless every tither, every offering giver, Lord Jesus. Help us to participate in all the other avenues of giving that you've presented before us, God. We just thank you for the opportunity, and we thank you for your promised blessings, Lord. We receive it with gladness. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come, choir.
Water you turned into wine.
Our God is greater, our God is stronger.
us for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? What can stand against?
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. He's been my fourth man in the fire, time after time. Born of His Spirit, I'm washed in His blood, and what He did for me on Calvary is more than enough. I trust in God, my Savior, the one who will never fail. He will never fail.
Lord, and He heard, and He answered.
answered every prayer that I've given unto him because I trust him. And I tell him every day that I trust you, God, in my mountain, in my valley. You are Alpha and Omega, beginning and the end. Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Jireh. And I will trust you to the end of my days. I tell you in this moment that I trust you in my life, with my worship and my praise. God, to you I give all my life, and not my will, but yours be done, Lord. Tell him, church, tell him that he's the one that you trust, God.
Lift your voice and sing it. He's never going to fail you. Just your voices. I trust in God, my Savior, the one. Be a great big choir today. He will never fail. Sing it again. I trust
in God.
Yes.
My Savior.
Lift up your faith. Lift up your praise.
Will never fail. He will never fail.
Through it all. Through it all.
trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God through it all. That's it. If you know it, sing it.
Through it all, I've learned to depend upon His word.
Sing it again. Sing through it all.
Through it all.
Through my tears and sorrow.
Through it all.
I trust Him with every tomorrow. I've learned to trust in Jesus.
I've learned to trust in God.
I'm trusting in take it up.
Through it all.
I've learned
to trust in Jesus.
That's it. I need some elders to testify right now. You know this song. Sing it out.
Through it all.
Yeah.
Through it all.
Come on, I need a testimony of praise in this place. Come on, you were lost, and the devil said you just need to give up. You don't need any chance. You don't deserve a chance of hope and peace and love in your life. But you got tired of the devil's lies, and you got tired of feeling downtrodden all the time. So you went to a meeting one night, and your soul wasn't right, but you sought the Lord, and He answered, and He didn't leave you like you came in. You came in changed. You came in redeemed. Do we have a choir full of people that are full of the Holy Ghost this morning? Then give the Lord a praise. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Hallelujah. Hey, can we just testify a little bit? We in D. For anyone who's ever seen the mountain of your sin just disappear. For anyone who's ever felt the hand of heaven reach down through your fears. Dry your tears for any life that once was empty that now finds itself alive and full of song, brother. You got a brand new song. Oh, then you'll understand the reason for the way the saints of God are gonna carry on. Oh,
when I shout, no, I'm shouting from a heart that's been washed clean. When I run, no, I'm running from a past that's been redeemed. To the world it might look crazy, but there's just no telling what you're gonna do. In that moment Jesus gets a hold of you.
Hey! For anyone who knows the hope that keeps them moving on through troubled days, and for anyone who knows you got a future and a hope beyond the grave. Come on. Every life's a different story. How He brought us out of darkness into His marvelous light. Help me now. There's no way.
There's no way to keep us silent.
Every breath's another chance to testify. I need somebody to testify this morning.
When I shout, no, I'm shouting from From a heart that's been washed clean. When I run, no, I'm running. From a past that's been redeemed.
This world.
To the world, it might look crazy. There's just no telling what you're gonna do.
Now, my past erased, my name, he's changed. I'm gonna testify. My past erased, my name, he has changed. Let's testify. Come on, choir. Real voice, one voice, one voice.
My past erased, my name, he changed. Let's testify.
Come on, church. Come on, church, testify, testify.
My past erased, my name he changed, let's testify.
When I shout, know that I'm shouting.
When I shout, know I'm shouting. From a heart that's been washed clean. When I run, know I'm running. From a past that's been redeemed. To the world, it might look crazy. There's just no telling what you're gonna do.
Somebody testify. Yeah.
My past erased. My name he changed. Let's testify.
My past erased.
My past erased. My name he changed. Let's testify.
Oh, somebody testify.
My past erased. My name he changed. Let's testify.
Now, if you think, if you came here to look a little cute this morning, you're in the wrong church. Because I didn't come here to look cute, and I didn't come here to do a good dance for the social media profiles. I don't care if it's ugly. I'm come to give a praise to the Lord because it's beautiful in His sight. Because I was living on the ugly side of life. I was lost and I was down. I was in sin and I was backslidden. But the Lord, but the Lord, but the Lord. So if I get down here and I can't help myself but praise Him, and I can't help myself but run, and I can't help myself but shout, and I can't help but clap, it may seem a little wild to you, but don't you judge me. Don't you dare judge me, because you don't know like I know. If you think that I'm being too loud, you ain't seen nothing yet. If you think I'm undignified now, you ain't seen nothing yet. I will dance, I will run, I will shout, shout till there's nothing left. I've come to praise Him with all that I have. Praise till there's nothing left. If you think I'm being too loud.
If you think that I'm being too loud.
You ain't seen nothing.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Come on. If you think.
If you think I'm undignified now.
Come on, choir.
You ain't seen
come on,
nothing
choir.
Yet.
Let the redeemed say so. I will
dance. I will run. Shout,
I'm gonna shout
till there's nothing left.
I'm not gonna leave here until
I will praise you with all that I have.
Praise
till there's nothing left.
Praise till there's nothing left.
Praise till there's nothing left.
Praise till there's nothing left.
Praise till there's nothing left.
I'm gonna give Him my all.
Praise till there's nothing left.
I'm gonna give Him my
praise.
Your hands in the house. church this morning. Something got a hold of me. That's why I dance.
That's why I dance like it's my last chance. I have been set free.
And I will shout, I will shout.
I will shout till I'm out of breath.
I'll be the first.
I'll be the first to tell you. I don't know how to explain how he changed my life.
Yeah.
But when Jesus changed me, something got a hold of me.
Oh, I want to tell it again. I said, if you think that I'm being too loud, you ain't seen nothing yet. And if you think I'm a little undignified now, oh, sister, you ain't seen nothing yet. Help me.
I will dance, I will run, I will shout, shout till there's nothing left.
I will praise you.
I will praise you with all that.
There's nothing.
Praise till there's nothing left.
Somebody better.
Praise till there's nothing left.
Somebody better.
Praise till there's something left.
Hey, oh.
Praise till there's nothing left.
Something got a hold of me. That's why I dance.
That's why I dance like it's my last chance.
I have been set free. I'm gonna shout, gonna shout. Somebody praise the Lord. If you've been redeemed by love divine and you're not ashamed of it, and if you think, hey, don't let the suit and tie fool you. Don't let all the cute outfits fool you. We're sinners saved by grace just like everybody else. And I'm not ashamed to give my Lord demonstrative praise, because I was gone. You were gone. You had no hope. You had no chance of making it. But the Lord stepped in and made a way. Hell lost another one. I am free. I am free. I need us to testify. If you're glad you've been saved, I need you to sing this right now.
I am free.
It's not because of anything you've done, but because of the Lord.
Hell lost another one.
That's it, praise the Lord.
Hell lost another one.
I am free.
I am free. I am free.
Sing it again.
Hell lost another one. I am free. I am free.
Come on, church.
I am free.
Hell lost.
Hell lost another one. I am free. I am free. I am free.
He picked me up.
He picked me up. He turned me around.
And you see all these people up here, all these wonderful, beautiful people of God. You know what we're getting ready to tell you? If he did it for me, he can do it for you. If he did it for me, he can do it for your family. He can do it for your neighborhood. He can do it for this city. So let this song echo out of this church today, that you don't have to stay the same way you are. We're telling you, get up, get up, get up. Get up out of that grave.
Get up, get up, get up. Get up out of that grave.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Get up, get up, get up.
Step out.
Get up out of that grave.
Step out from where you're at.
Get up, get up.
And praise the Lord.
Get up out of that grave.
Get up, get up,
get up. Get up, get up, get up. Get up out of that grave. Get up, get up, get up. Get up out of that grave.
You don't have to stay there.
Get up, get up, get up. Get up out of that grave. Get up, get up, get up.
He gave me. victory.
I'm dancing out of my grave clothes. For whom the sun sets free is free indeed. Morning's here and I'm grateful.
And I'm so grateful.
For the Savior God of victory.
I'm
dancing out of my grave clothes. Who the sun sets free.
If you want redemption,
get up out of that grave. Get up out of that grave. Get up.
If you want redemption, if you want forgiveness of your sins, step out. Lift up your hands right where you're at. Ask the Lord to touch you. Say, Lord, forgive me. I've heard you calling my name, and I don't want to stay the same anymore. God will meet you right where you're at. He will fill you with His Spirit.
Get up out of that grave.
Hey.
Get up.
He picked me up.
He picked me up. He turned me around. He placed my feet on solid ground. I thank the Master. I thank the Savior.
Oh,
because He healed my heart.
And
He changed my name.
And now forever.
Savior, I thank God.
Hallelujah. Woo! I think it'd be all right if we just kept praising the Lord just a little bit right here. Because you thought you were gone. Choir. Has God been good to you?
Yes.
Hey, Sister Susie. Has God been good? Has God been faithful? Brother, has God been faithful? Hey, He's not done yet. He's not done yet. I'm telling you, something happens when our praises and our faith intertwine and we meet. Nothing pleases the Lord more than to hear the sounds of our praise. And especially when faith is matched with that, He loves to hear the sounds of faith. It moves Him. It causes Him to step in the room and say, all right, what do these people need right now? And maybe you're right, that sister who gave that testimony today, you are facing things that you have no control over. But everything that's over your head, it's under His feet. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. He is the author and the finisher of our faith. I believe, I testify, God's been good to me. Through every test and trial, I got the victory. I tell the enemy, he's tried his best to make me turn around, bring me down. But my God's never failed me yet, so I'm gonna stand my ground. I said, my God's never failed me yet, so I'm gonna stand my ground. The devil comes and he tries to get you to just sit down. Sit down. That devil just wants you to sit down. Are you going to stay seated? When the devil tells you to sit down and shut your mouth, what are you going to do? You're going to praise the Lord. You're going to stand up. You're going to rise up again. And it's not because of anything you've done, but it's because of the Lord. And when the enemy comes and attacks you in the night and tells you that you're nothing, you're not worthy to show up on Sunday, you're going to show up anyway. When the devil comes and tells you that you are a loser and you are not worth any amount of grace that God could give you, you're going to say, you've already been defeated. The tomb is empty. And I don't see the end, but I know who holds tomorrow. And I'm going to praise Him anyhow. Choir, are you ready? I believe, I'll testify, God's been good to me.
Through every test and trial, I've got the victory.
Hey,
the enemy has tried his best to make me turn around, bring me down.
Yeah,
And my God's never failed me yet, so I'm gonna stand my ground.
No matter,
no matter what comes my way, I lift my voice and say,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
anyhow. Wait a minute, one more time, I think I'll say it again. God's been too good to me, and he's my closest friend. I've come too far to turn around now.
I'm gonna stand, I'm gonna wait, watch God work it out somehow. No matter what comes my way, I'll lift my voice and say, hallelujah.
God's been too good to me, and he's my closest friend. I've come too far to turn around now. I'm gonna stand, I'm gonna wait, watch God work it out somehow. No matter what comes my way, I'll lift my voice and say, hallelujah, anyhow.
God's been good to me through every test and trial. I got the victory. God's been good to me. Through every test and trial, I got the victory.
No matter what comes,
no matter what comes my way, I'll lift my voice and say, hallelujah, anyhow. God's been good to me.
Through every test and trial,
through every test and trial, I got the victory.
Come on.
Test and trial, I got the victory.
No matter what comes,
no matter what comes my way, I'll lift my voice and say, hallelujah, anyhow.
I believe, I'll testify,
God's been good to me. Through every test and trial, I got the victory. The enemy is trying his best to make me turn around, bring me down.
But my God,
I've never failed me yet, so I'm gonna stand my ground.
No matter
It's all right to praise the Lord right now. It's all right to praise him. It's all right to lift your voice and give him a loud praise. Make this place shake with the sound of praise. Make this place loud with noise of praise. He's worthy. He's worthy of more than a cutesy little golf clap. The King of Israel danced as they brought the ark back into Jerusalem, and he was mocked by his own wife. You know what? I don't care who you are or who's sitting next to you. Don't you let anybody inhibit your praise today. God ain't pleased with anybody's ego. He's pleased with somebody who humbly praises the Lord. And it may be demonstrative, but you don't know like I know what he's done for me. Choir, thank you so much. Give this choir a hand. I put them through the gauntlet this morning. If you would stay standing, let me bring a word of the Lord. Musicians, after I'm done, don't go too far. I don't think I'm going to be too long. Are you praising the Lord because I'm not going to be too long? God is good. I want to give honor to your pastor and his family, Brother and Sister Fielder, Brother and Sister McFarland. First time I met Brother McFarland was at camp. We were on the praise team that night together and found that, wow, this is like the nicest guy I think that's ever been made by God's hand. This is a really nice guy. And I don't know why I'm up here. Your pastor has a killer voice. I love your pastor's voice. And that sense. Praise God. There we go. All right, you are dismissed. God's doing great things in this church. And I'm here to encourage. That's what the job of the evangelist really is. I'm here to encourage the church. And choir, I know you're tired, but I know you just went back to your seats, but I need you to preach with me now. I need the church to preach with me. I need the redeemed of the Lord to say so while I preach today. Because somebody is going to be filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. And the waters are ready for baptism in his name as well. In the name of Jesus, we believe it. He does all things well in his time. Hallelujah. And I'm so glad to be here in this season. In John chapter 3, verse number 7, Jesus is speaking to Nicodemus. Actually, let's start at verse number 5. Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Boom. That's it. Settled. Jesus said it. I believe it. It's settled. I believe every word of this book right here. I believe every book, every word. I believe that there was a flood. I believe that God, when the Egyptians had the Israelites trapped, God made a way through the Red Sea. When this Bible said that that happened, I believe that it happened. And so I believe when Jesus said in this book, in his conversation, in secret with Nicodemus, he said, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of flesh is flesh, and that which is born of spirit is spirit. Marvel not, I say unto thee, ye must be born again. Verse 8, the wind bloweth where it listeth. And thou hearest the sound thereof, but cannot tell whence it comes and whither it goes. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. Tonight, this morning, I just want to tell you, the wind makes it wild. The wind makes it wild. You may be seated. But don't stay seated too long now. How many know God's ways are higher than our own? How many know God does all things well? He is nothing ever catches him by surprise. The worst thing that's happened in your life, God saw it. And he has grace sufficient enough to keep you for it. You are not out of his hand unless we leave. We have a giving problem here in the church. We have a giving up problem. Because sometimes we receive the joy of the Lord. We receive his salvation. But the world can't take it because they didn't give it. But we can give it up. We can only hold so much. And so we get bombarded by other things in life. And something's got to drop. And unfortunately, sometimes in the church, we give up doing right. But he never gives up on us. He's never left us nor forsaken us. I told a little bit of my testimony today. I was backslidden, but on the pew. I showed up because I didn't want anybody calling me and nagging me about not coming to church. You know those sweet people. They mean the best, but they drive you nuts when you miss. Where were you today? Didn't see you today. It wasn't the same without you. And if you're that sweet saint, God bless you because you're doing the Lord's work. And you know, those if it wasn't for those people who I just did not want to feel bad about just skipping the call or just being rude, that convicted me to be in the house of God at least, even though I didn't want to be there when I was just a teenager. Isn't it amazing how you get older but you get dumber? It's just, I don't know. I got the Holy Ghost when I was 9 years old. And I thought, well, it's smooth sailing from here. Oof. Yeah, not quite. But I became a teenager. And then I found out real quick, everything I was blaming the devil for was really just my fault. We give the devil a little too much credit sometimes. Really, we're our own worst enemy. Because of the decisions that we make. But God's grace is sufficient for you. It doesn't matter how dark it is in your home. It doesn't matter how hopelessly lost you think someone is or you feel today. The darkness and the sin cannot keep up with the amount of grace that God can outpour in this service today. I tell you right now, God is already moving on hearts today. Throughout the service, throughout the worship service, while we were praying for the sick, God's already restoring and moving and putting homes back together. And he's already, you don't even see it, but he's taking care of the job need. He's taking care of the money issue. But he's wondering, even if you don't see the end, are you still going to praise him? Are you still going to lift up a shout of praise? Are you still going to dance? Where's that? I didn't see her. Where's that Sister Trimble that you were talking about? She's passed. God bless her. You don't know what the power of praise does. And we feel entitled. We feel entitled so much of the Lord to see. What, you know, what's that lyric say? Even though I don't see it, he's working. Well, that's easy to sing, but ooh, it's a lot harder to live. But thank God for Sister Trimble who got it. She got it in her spirit. Even though I may not see it yet, but I'm praising in advance. And it may just be a little shuffle. It may just be a little cry. It's all I can muster. But even though it's just 2 pence, it's all I have. He wants it all. And you watch it take that praise and multiply the blessing. Because everything that you're praying for, he hasn't been deaf to it. He hears your prayers in the night. He's heard your prayers this morning. And I'm encouraging this church today, be of good cheer. The Lord is on your side. God is not done. God is not done. God is not finished. Revival is happening right now. And it's not over today. It's going to continue. Do you know the power? Do you know the intensity of a wildfire? We've all seen it down in Texas and in the Southwest and in California. It's devastating. We've seen how it devastated the Appalachia area in Tennessee not too long ago and in parts of West Virginia and in Virginia. It ravaged the land. People lost homes. People lost lives. And it took the beauty of the landscape away. Yet, what the natural fire does, the spiritual fire does something completely different. The fire of God, it destroys the natural flesh. But in doing so, it restores the beauty of the soul to where it was meant to be. In Acts chapter 2, in verse number 1, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all in one place and in one accord. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave the utterance. I'm telling somebody, when the fire falls, it comes and the wind blows where it wants, but it hears the call of the sinner. It hears the call of the heart. It hears you today, and it hears your desperate cry for to be made whole and to be clean again, to be full. I told you, I was backslidden and on the pew. But I was miserable. I had no peace. I had no rest. I had no joy. I had no comfort because I was showing up, but I was running from the call of God. I was miserable. I was just stuck in the belly of a whale that I had just ran into. But then I heard a song from my childhood. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. And something broke within me. And I came to an old-fashioned altar. And I said, God, I don't care if I ever preach or if I ever sing again. I don't care. I just want to know that I'm saved. I just want to know that I'm yours. I just want peace again. I had peace and I gave it up. But I want peace again. Give me joy again. Forgive me. And in a moment, I felt it was like hot oil from the top of my head to the sole of my feet, a warmth that covered my body. As I prayed back through, and God's grace met me in that moment, and I've never turned away since. But something also was birthed in me. It was a fire that said, all right, whatever you tell me to do, God, I'll do it. Whatever you, because I felt the wind blow on me. And I have now fire in my soul. And do you know what makes a wildfire so dangerous? It's not the fire itself, but it's when the wind carries a spark across the field that catches another place on fire and it spreads like crazy. It's not the fire that does it. It's the wind that makes it wild. And I'm telling the church here in Portage today that if you're ready for it, the wind can blow into this house and it can blow into your prayer closet at home and it can set this place ablaze. Not just this room, but it'll leave the four walls of this house and it'll set the whole city on fire. And there won't be room in this place to hold the sinners, to hold the people that are hungry for a change in their lives. Ooh, I see it in the spirit. I see people sitting in these pews and in the balconies, and you got to set chairs out in front of here, and there's almost no rooms in the altar, but there are cries unto God for repentance, for touchings of grace and mercy, and they're all because, why? Because there is a church here today that will not stop, that will not give up on the call of God. They'll say, God, whatever you gotta do, just set us loose. Wind blow on us right now. Make this church wild with praise. Make this church wild with faith. Make this church yours and just let it spread. Fill us with fire. Fill us with new anointing. Fill us with new strength. Fill us with new hope. Fill us with renew us, Lord, in this place. Do I got a witness? Do I got one somebody who wants to be a part of this church? That wants to be a part of this church triumphant? Some of us think, well, people aren't going to come because nothing's really happening here. You think that just because this is normal church, that it's not good enough. We need to see signs, miracles, signs, and wonders. That's what we need in this place. You are strangely disillusioned because it is a miracle and a sign and a wonder to witness the outpouring of the Holy Ghost on a sinner that has cried out. It's a miracle that they're even alive still today, that grace would carry them, to give them one more chance, to lean on them more than they did yesterday, to give them more than they ever hoped that they could have. I'm telling you, it's a sign of the times that God is pouring out His Spirit upon all flesh. And hey, you will be in a place where your sons and daughters will be involved and they'll be preaching and prophesying and teaching. But right now, you need to be raising them up and teaching them. Youth pastor, Chris, thank God that you brought some people to a youth rally and you have young people that are not afraid to witness and bring somebody there. And they had a young girl there that was filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. We don't need a cute little golf clap for that, because I'm telling you, all of heaven rejoiced. Heaven was loud. They got loud when they saw that girl repent of her sins, and God filled her with His Spirit. God is outpouring His Spirit here in Portage, and He's relying on this church. That's the message I have, is He's relying on this church. Because many are so hungry. And many just want to be made whole again. It's a wonder to see His wonders unfold in the altar. When a sinner raises their hands. And I feel a little checked right there. Don't push back on the word sinner. Don't do that. Don't let your flesh inhibit what God wants to do in your life today. The first step is to say, I am not well. And I do need the Lord. I need Him to take all of me. Not just part, not just my time for an hour or two on Sunday. He's got to have all of me for me to be whole again. I don't know why people turn away from the Lord. I've been asking that question of myself for a long time. I didn't even know why I did it. Basically, it narrows down to this. People just want to do what they want to do. And you will find that when you turn your mind, when you're sick and tired, when you're just sick and tired of being lost, and you say, I want to do what He wants to do, that's when the change happens. That's when you have an opportunity to be filled anew with fresh fire. And let the wind carry you to your family, to your friends, to all that you come in contact with. Your witness, this revival that you're in, it's not coming. You're in it. This revival that you're a part of, It is depending on your commitment. Because many are hungry. They want salvation. They want to experience true peace and joy and love, and they need you. So stand with me all across this place. And lift up your hands unto the Lord right now. God is moving on hearts and minds right now. God is moving. God is moving. Would you talk to the Lord right now? Say, God, use me. God, put me where you need me. If I'm away from where you need me to be, God, put me where you need me. I'm not rejecting your will anymore. Come on, church. We need to be in the will of the Lord. Come on, somebody. It's been a long time since you've prayed through. It's been a long time since you've prayed until there was a breakthrough. We need to be full, full of the Holy Ghost. Church, you got to have a desire to be full of the fire. He is the God that answers by fire. He is the Lord. And he will have a church, Portage. He will have a church. Are you going to be part of it? Because churches become empty because people are involved, but they are not committed. They are not. They'll show up for the hype stuff, but they're not committed to staying saved and sanctified. Feel this in the Holy Ghost right now. Church, as they begin to play, I want to open these altars right now. And you need to pray. Elders, you need to be leading this prayer right now. You need to be leading this prayer, elder saints of God. We need to have a desire to pray until it breaks through. Pray until there is healing. Pray until the salvation comes. Pray, tarry until the fire falls, until the wind blows from heaven. You need to pray, so come. If you desire fresh fire from the Lord, then come. If you desire for a renewing of your faith, if you want to pray, if you have not prayed through to the Holy Ghost, it's been a long time. I'm encouraging you to come, step out. And if you are wanting to be involved in the kingdom of God, you need to be in this altar. You need to have a desire to be full of His Spirit, full of His Spirit. And if you have been seeking the salvation of God, come. Come join us. Come join us. God wants to fill you with His Spirit. But you need to just lift up your hands all across this place. We're not going to leave anybody. We're not going to make anybody embarrassed. We're all going to seek it right now. We're all going to seek the presence of God and the gift of His salvation. God, I need you, Jesus. That's where it starts. I need you, Lord. I need you, Lord. God, fire fall on me. God, fall on me. No power in this world. There is nothing that the enemy can whisper in your ear that our God cannot speak to. His love surpasses the enemy's lies. That's it, church. That's it, church. Seek the Lord right now. Seek the Lord right now. Jesus, we need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. That's it. Brothers and sisters, bind together. Bind and pray for one another. Lord, we need fire, God. We need fire, Lord, to fall.
All to Jesus I surrender. All to Him I freely give.
Oh, yes.
I will ever love and trust Him in His presence. Presence daily live, and I.
sing it.
I surrender
all to thee, yes.
All to thee, my
blessed Savior.
I surrender all.
Sing, I surrender. This is a beautiful song to sing, but it's an even harder song to live. Mothers, fathers, gather your children together. If you're here by yourself, link up with the family close to you. We're the church of the living God, and we're a family together. God is not done in this service. I want us to link up together and I want us to pray. The power of God that we feel on Sunday, and Pastor will tell you, it doesn't stay in the church house. So come on. I want fathers, mothers, I want you to ask the Lord, fill me anew. I want us to pray till there's breakthrough today. I want us to pray. I want us to pray without any music right now. I want all the musicians to pray right now. I want us to pray till there's breakthrough. Lift up your voice right now. Call out after the Lord. That's it. That's it. Hallelujah. God, we need you. God, we need you. We can't do this without you. We cannot have breakthrough without you. We cannot have revival without you. That's it, that's it, that's it. Turn your cares unto the Lord. Put everything on Him. God, we lean on you, Jesus. We lean on you, Jesus. We lean on you, Lord. We need your power. We need your strength. That's it, that's it, that's it, that's it. Horiera boshikea tarobo shikala raboheya. Sikiata raborieta la rabosikiata hera. Oh God, oh God, we're not tired. We're not going to get weary in well doing. We're going to tarry until the fire falls. We're going to tarry until the wind blows and carries us across this city. Lord, help us set this city ablaze with the truth of your gospel, with the revelation of who you are. God, you are Jesus. Your name is Jesus. And you've come to save. You've come to save. God, we need your touch. We need your touch. We can't do it without you, God. We can't do this without you, Lord. We need the power of your Spirit in this house. That's it, young man, young woman. Seek after the Lord. Seek out after the Lord. Lift up your voice right where you're at. God is moving. God is moving in this house. Hallelujah. Keep praying, Lord. Keep praying, church. God is moving in this house. God is moving in this house. Breakthrough is happening. Breakthrough is happening in families. Breakthrough is happening in hearts and lives. Jesus, we seek your face right now. God, Lord, touch Ariel. Let your power cover her. Let your love surround her, Lord, right now. Touch her, Jesus. 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 Touch her, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 That's it, Ariel. That's the love of God. That's the love of the Lord. That's it. That's it. That's it. Yes, oh yes.
All to thee, my blessed Savior, I
surrender. One verse says,
all to Jesus I surrender, I receive that sacred. flame. High, oh, the joy of pure salvation. I'm singing glory, glory to His name. I surrender all. Sing it, church. I surrender all to Thee now, to Thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender. Oh, I surrender. I surrender all. Yes, I do. Church, let's just clap our hands and thank the Lord. Don't forget how the church started, prayer meeting. And it's going to take a love for prayer. It's not just for the church in Portage. It's for the church in this last day. The church that loves prayer is the church that will succeed in reaching the lost. We've got to have a love for His presence. We've got to have a love for His house. Not just showing up and being involved, but committed. Because we've got to have a desire for fire. And to just say, Lord, let Your wind blow. Take me wherever You want me to be. Lord, if You need me to be a witness over in the grocery store over there, I'll be a witness. I appreciate your pastor. I know he's ministering right now. I appreciate this church. Thank you for allowing me to share my heart today. Pastor, I love you. Hey, God's moving. God's moving. Ariel, God's moving. God's moving on you. God's moving on you. Hey, if I may be so bold, God's moving on families. God's moving on families. You gotta want it. You gotta want this more than anything else, because there's nothing in the world. There is nothing. A song says, there's nothing, God, better than You. There's nothing better than You. Because you can search this world over and you'll never find a love like the Lord's. I promise you. So hold fast. Hold fast. There's nothing better than this right here. Being in the presence of God and just letting Him move. Amen. One more time. Would you clap your hands and give the Lord praise?
Even when we can't see it, even when we don't see it right now, what happened at this altar call, we're going to see it. Amen. We're going to hear about change that happened. Amen. Sister Ariel, God's doing a work. You just stay sensitive. Amen. Brother Harley, praise God. We're so glad y'all are here today. Amen. Aaron, God's doing a work in your family. Amen. Chris, God's doing a work. Andrea, just continue to let Him. Continue to let Him. Amen. Continue to let Him. There's nothing like living for the Lord. Nothing like living for the Lord. This is the best thing that's going. Amen. Quickly, by way of announcements, please just stay right where you're at. Ladies, if you've registered for the Indiana Ladies Conference, please let my wife know. We need an exact number in attendance for seating. Registration is also open for the ladies, the PUPC Ladies Day Luncheon. You can register on our church app or with Sister Angie or Sister Gretchen. The cost is $25 and is due at the time of registration. The last day to sign up is today. And then ladies' Bible study, you saw it on the screen, is Tuesday at 6:30 at the Family Center. It's going to be a great time. And then Girls for God is Sunday, April 28th, following the service down at the Family Center. Pickleball and pizza. I like it in that order. Because if you eat pizza, pickleball is going to be challenging. Amen. But it's going to be a good time. Pickleball and pizza and fellowship. And then following service for our Oasis group, they already did a silent auction for some of the dessert items. But please, before you leave, make your way out to the foyer and bid on some great desserts. This is going to our Oasis group and different events that they have. We want to bless them. And then listen up real quick, if I can have your attention. I do want to say Brother Soto shared an awesome testimony before church. He was able to give the plan of salvation, share the plan of salvation with Sister Bruni's mother in Spanish. I love it. Sister Bruni said it was the most beautiful plan of salvation that she's ever heard in Spanish. And her mother received it and has repented. And we are praying. We are praying for her in Jesus' name. Thank you, Brother Soto. The Spanish ministry has already started. And she's going to be here May 5th in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to have a great bilingual service. Amen. I'm going to preach and Brother Soto is going to interpret. Our songs are going to be in English and Spanish. We're just going to have a good time. God loves every language, every ethnicity. His hallelujah in every language. He's lifted up across this globe in every nation. Amen. And we're thankful to have that here. So thank you, Brother Soto, for being sensitive to the Lord. Amen. Make sure you get by and greet Brother Devin Cunningham. We're so thankful. One more time, let's give him a hand for being here. Thank you for ministering to us. And my, singing. I love it. I love his voice. I love his anointing and his preaching. What a great day to be a child of God. God bless you. You're dismissed in Jesus' name.